Robbery, hey, unfortunately does happen. And that's why there are laws on the books that punish people who engage in robbery. There are also laws on the books that when a robbery takes place with a gun, the person carrying that gun gets a bigger prison sentence. There are also laws that say if that gun goes off during the robbery, there's even a bigger prison sentence. And that's what brings us to this week's case. It involves a guy named Michael Hobbs. He was involved in a bank robbery. Went in carrying a gun. During the bank robbery, he fumbled the gun. The gun fell to the floor. It went off. Nobody was hurt. He was convicted of the bank robbery. And at the sentencing, the judge sentenced him to another 10 years in prison under a law that said if a gun goes off during a robbery, you get another 10 years. He said, this isn't fair. This isn't fair. I didn't intend to have the gun go off. Nobody got hurt. And through his lawyers argued, all criminal law has an element of intent required. You have to show that the person intended the robbery, intended the rape, intended the embezzlement. Usually you can infer that from the kind of conduct that takes place, but you have to show that intent. He said, here there is no intent, no intent. U.S. Supreme Court considered this case, considered it carefully, and they said there is enough generalized intent in going into a bank carrying a gun to make you responsible for a law that holds you strictly liable under criminal penalties for having a gun that goes off. That makes sense. It makes sense, according to the court, because society doesn't want people carrying guns into buildings, threatening people, especially if those guns are loaded, because things can happen that result in harm. And when you carry a gun, you know you may cause some significant injury, some significant harm, you might kill somebody. Therefore, we find there was enough generalized intent in carrying that gun in to make you responsible for another 10 years. Okay, we bring you this case and we bring you cases every week so you understand how the law works, so you understand how you can make the law work for you, but better understand what happens when you read those newspaper stories and why was another 10 years given or why did something else happen. We want you to understand the law. And you know what? The law often has a lot of common sense in it. You've got a lot of common sense too. I'm David Allen.